Hey, that's me, Anthony, a software engineer in his natural habitat. I have my ass on this chair in front of my laptop for most of my days. It's 1 AM, London is well asleep, my eyes hurt, my brain is fried, but I'm still here, coding, looking at fixing this one last bug I'm stuck on.
I'm honestly so deep into it now that not fixing it will prevent me from sleeping anyway.
Said like that, you might think that I hate my job, but the truth is, I freaking love it. Let me tell you why. Okay, hear me out on this one. I think there's something almost magical about coding. You enter a sequence of characters in a computer with a language you both understand, and the computer is smart enough to translate it to the experience you envisioned.
Very few people really understand that almost everything we do each day is actually detected by code.
Like when you're looking for the next perfect location for your holidays in Iceland,
or let you create Vitigo on Photoshop, shop anything on Amazon and get delivered the next day. You don't know something, just Google it. If you feel lonely tonight, Tinder is your friend. Every services are being digitalized and are becoming commodities. They are making our lives so much easier that it's hard to remember how our lives were before them. And all of that is made through code by a developer just like me. I mean, like me, I'm still stuck on the same bug. Okay, Anthony, do something else for a bit. Like checking developers arguing on the internet. That's always fun. Okay, Angular versus React. Okay, that's a dumb idea. I might as well never sleep with this debate. Everyone knows that React is better. Okay, let's find something else. Or why not is coding an art? Some people on the internet argue that coding is an art you express through a computer. Coding for me is a language, as much that painting is a language as well, that you have to learn too. The only difference is that for us developers, our canvas is really a sassy b**** and tell you that your art doesn't work. Sometimes you write code and it works and sometimes it doesn't. You don't know why. That's your job to figure it out. And you got to be ready to face that every single day. People are crazy enough to create actual pieces of art out of HTML and CSS. Look at that. This attention to details. Everything is represented by a line of code. This is pure insanity, and I love that. Non-tech people really think that programmers are a bunch of weirdos talking in zero and ones. But programming isn't that hard. In fact, I believe that anyone can learn it as long as you're ready to put time and effort into it. But it's well worth it. The results are pretty damn cool. She's not the first one asking me that too. And I can get why. Learning to code can be overwhelming at first. Okay. Where do I even start?
I can't really speak for everyone. But I can tell you how I would learn it if I had to do it again.
It's super late, but let's do something quick for her. The best way to learn anything, and especially to code, is in my opinion to have a clear plan and a clear goal in mind. Trust me, I've only got half a brain and it worked for me. You really need to learn by intention, meaning you need to solve the how to get where. Coding is all about problem solving. The where can be anything. You might want to start a blog, launch a new Tinder for dogs, or create the website for a business you have in mind. You've got to start small, and I think web development is one of the easiest and most versatile skills you can pick up right now. With that, you'll be able to create website, mobile app, APIs, speak 6, even use JavaScript in their Rocket user interface. To reach your goal, you need to start by the basics. Learn HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. A good analogy is that HTML is the skeleton of the website, CSS is the skin and the clothes, and JavaScript is the brain. You can use Codecademy for that. I used it to learn JavaScript in 2012, and their approach is really cool. You learn by doing. You can also check out W3 Schools and Mozilla. Those are free resources. I started learning coding alone without any guidance and help. And I wish I had someone to guide me in the right direction and help me focus on the right things. This is maybe one of the most important tips that will make you grow so much faster. Find a mentor. They'll help you when you're stuck, they'll motivate you, and more importantly, they will inspire you. Do not only watch videos thinking you've learned something. You've got to do it yourself to truly leave a mark in your brain. I don't know how many times I've been sleeping with video in playback, thinking I was actually learning something. Now you know the basics. Congrats. It's time to get your hand dirty and code a real-life example. Take a website that you love, or pick a design on Dribbble and just code it yourself. There are simple yet cool design to be inspired from. I highly recommend you to spend some time doing that. Then, when you get comfortable with the basics, you can start to learn React. It's one of the most popular and most used in the industry. This will unlock powerful web and mobile app development for you. It's used by all your favorite websites like Facebook, Airbnb, Instagram, Shopify, PayPal, Dropbox, to name a few. Once again, you can learn it on Codecademy or on the official doc, which is quite complete. Then start the real deal, the thing that will set you up for success. Work on a real-life example or a personal project. If you have no idea what to do, just copy something. This is what I did in the past. Those are project ideas that you can try to copy. They are easy concepts that you can try to implement yourself. You need to go out of your comfort zone and learn new stuff. But that's what it's all about, right? Fail, learn, repeat, until you have something to show off to the world. You will get stuck for sure, but be certain that someone already had the same issue and you're not alone. Just Google it. A good developer is just a master in Googling, but they are too proud to admit. Okay, I'm done. Let's push that and send it to her. Okay. It's getting late, but I really want to fix this bug. I'm so freaking close, I can feel it. Not allowed to local resources. Okay, let's Google that. I'm so dumb. I forgot to start the local server. Okay, let's do that real quick. Bugs. There we go. Hello. Fuck. Okay, I think I know why. Let's fix that real quick. Okay. I forgot the last edge case. And voila. Man, this is so useless, but I love it. Look at that, it's so cool. It takes the video feed from a camera and changes pixel to ASCII characters, creating this funny looking version of myself. This is exactly why I love coding. Regardless of what you're working on, nothing beats this feeling of creating something new and learning. Okay, it's time to sleep now. Good night. Hey, I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to leave a comment, subscribe if you feel like it, and I'm sure you'll be liking the video I've done previously about how to successfully create side project as a software engineer. And I think that's it. Yeah, see you on the next video. Bye.